A very good day to all of you, and we welcome you all to this service in the name of our triune God.
And the four living creatures, each of them with six wings, are full of eyes all around and inside. Day and night, without ceasing, they sing, "Holy, holy, holy, the Lord God the Almighty, who was and is to come."
The Lord be with you.
Let us say the corporate confession together. Generous and merciful God, we confess to you and to our sisters and brothers that we have sinned against you, against one another, and against your creation in thought, word, and deed, through our ignorance, our weakness, and our deliberate disobedience. We are truly sorry. Forgive us all that is past, and grant us the gift of new life in Christ Jesus our Savior. Amen.
May the Almighty and merciful God grant unto you pardon and remission of all your sins, time for newness of life, and the grace and comfort of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Almighty and eternal God, you have revealed yourself as Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, and live and reign in the perfect
unity of love. Hold us firm in this faith, that we may know you in all your ways and evermore rejoice in your eternal glory, who is three persons in one God, now and forever. Amen.
The first lesson taken from Genesis chapter 1 and chapter 2, first 4 verses. In the beginning, when God created the universe, the earth was formless and desolate. The raging ocean that covered everything was engulfed in total darkness, and the power of God was moving over the water. Then God commanded, "Let there be light," and light appeared. God was pleased with what he saw. Then he separated the light from the darkness, and he named the light day and the darkness night. Evening passed and morning came. That was the first day. Then God commanded, "Let there be a dome to divide the water and to keep it in two separate places," and it was done. So God made a dome, and it separated the water under it from the water above it. He named the dome sky. Evening passed and morning came. That was the second day. Then God commanded, "Let the water below the sky come together in one place, so that the land will appear," and it was done. He named the land earth, and the water which had come together he named sea. And God was pleased with what he saw. Then he commanded, "Let the earth produce all kinds of plants, those that bear grain and those that bear fruits." And it was done. So the earth produced all kinds of plants, and God was pleased with what he saw. Evening passed and morning came. That was the third day. Then God commanded, "Let lights appear in the sky to separate day from night, and to show the time when days, years, and religious festivals begin. They will shine in the sky to give light to the earth," and it was done. So God made the two larger lights, the sun to rule over the day and the moon to rule over the night. He also made the stars. He placed the lights in the sky to shine on the earth, to rule over the day and the night, and to separate light from darkness. And God was pleased with what he saw. Evening passed and morning came. That was the fourth day. Then God commanded, "Let the water be filled with many kinds of living beings, and let the air be filled with birds." So God created the great sea monsters, all kinds of creatures that live in the water, and all kinds of birds. And God was pleased with what he saw. He blessed them all and told the creatures that live in the water to reproduce and to fill the sea. And he told the birds to increase in number. Evening passed and morning came. That was the fifth day. Then God commanded, "Let the earth produce all kinds of animal life, domestic and wild, large and small." And it was done. So God made them all, and he was pleased with what he saw. Then God said, "And now we will make human beings. They will be like us and resemble us. They will have power over the fish, the birds, and all animals, domestic and wild, large and small." So God created human beings, making them to be like himself. He created them male and female, blessed them and said, "Have many children, so that your descendants will live all over the earth and bring it under their control. I am putting you in charge of the fish, the birds, and all the wild animals. I have provided all kinds of grain and all kinds of fruit for you to eat. But for all the wild animals and for all the birds, I have provided grass and leafy plants for food. And this was done. God looked at everything he had made, and he was very pleased. Evening passed and morning came. That was the sixth day. And so the whole universe was completed. By the seventh day, God finished what he had been doing and stopped working. He blessed the seventh day and set it apart as a special day, because by that day he had completed his creation and stopped working. And that is how the universe was created. This is the word of Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 8. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. From the lips of children and infants you have ordained praise because of your enemies, to silence the foe and the avenger. When I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have set in place, what is man that you are mindful of him, the son of man that you care for him? You made him a little lower than the heavenly beings and crowned him with glory and honor. You made him ruler over the works of your hands. You put everything under his feet. All flocks and herds and the beasts of the field, the birds of the air and the fish of the sea, all that swim the paths of the seas. O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. Glory be to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The reading is taken from 2 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 11 to 13. Final greetings. Finally, brothers, goodbye. Aim for perfection. Listen to my appeal. Be of one mind. Live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the saints send their greetings. May the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. listen to the good news proclaimed in the Gospel according to St. Matthew, chapter 28, verses 16 to 20. Then the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshipped him, but some doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age." This is the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
In the beginning, when God created the heavens and the earth was a formless void, and darkness covered the face of the deep, while a wind from God swept over the face of the waters. Then God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw that the light was good, and God separated the light from the darkness. The Spirit of God hovered upon the waters, and God created us by His word. Father, the Creator God, Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, and the Son, the Word of God. Triune Godhead, yet one. The monotheistic approach of the Jews did not give way to understand the Spirit of God as a person. And as we know, they rejected the Son totally. Gospel according to John begins with similar words as it is found in Genesis, connecting Jesus to the Creator and the beginning. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through Him, and without Him, not one thing came into being. That has come into being in Him was life. And the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. The word of God that was spoken by God and read by humans during the time of the Old Testament has now taken flesh in Christ.
God gave the law through Moses, but grace and truth came through Jesus Christ.
The second person of Godhead, God the Son, the Savior. Paul confirms this further in his letter to the Colossians. He is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of all creation. For in Him all things in heaven and on earth were created, things visible and invisible. Whether thrones or dominions or rulers or powers, all things have been created through Him and for Him. He Himself is before all things, and in Him all things hold together. The Spirit of God that was there from the beginning also enters the world and our hearts and becomes the third person of the Godhead. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. Yet, Trinity is one word we never find in the Bible. But proof of its existence runs through the scriptures from beginning till the end. Trinity? What is that? It is the fact that our God is one, but reveals in three persons. The most elaborate event that one can find in the Bible of Trinity is the moment Jesus was baptized. This is my Son, the Beloved, with whom I am well pleased. The most common example we take is of water. May it be liquid, ice, or steam form, it continues to be H2O. Council of Nicaea in 325 AD that dealt with the relationship between God the Father and the Son ultimately decided that God the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit are one. Peace of the Lord be always with you.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. God of wind and fire, earth and water, who understands those mysteries that we can never fully comprehend, eradicate the pestilence that hovers among us by night and day, so that we may be saved from this deadly grip, and all people be restored to that life in which we will once again be free to welcome and walk with each other through Him who lived and walked among us, even Jesus our Lord. Amen. Your response to Lord in your mercy will be hear our prayer. God of passion, have mercy on people of our nations as we strive to protect one another and rid the world of this sinister virus that spreads fear, suffering, and death untold. Heal those who are sick with the virus. May they regain their strength and their health through quality medical care. Be with the doctors, nurses, researchers, and all medical professionals who seek to heal and help those affected and those who put themselves at risk in the process. May they know your protection and peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Watch over the poor, the homeless, the unemployed, immigrants and refugees, and provide for their every need, so that the coming days may not add to the burdens and deprivations that already crush them. Protect all those who repeatedly clean and disinfect public places and facilities so that they may remain alert and avert the dangers they are exposed to. guide all police and military personnel whose duty requires them to work among the public, and give them a blend of firmness and understanding so that our people and communities will remain calm and orderly. Be with the elders of all nations. Give them the foresight to act with charity and true concern for the well-being of the people they are meant to serve. Give them the wisdom to invest in long-term solutions that will help prepare or prevent future outbreaks. May they know your peace as they work together to achieve it on earth. Give wisdom, humility, and foresight to those who make policy decisions, and clarify and competence to those who implement these policies. And, O Lord, inspire all our citizens to care for one another as we care for our own, so that each will be protected and nourished by the other, and all work for the common good. Through Jesus, our courageous and caring companion. Amen.
And because you are children, God has sent the Spirit of His Son into our hearts, crying, Abba, Father. Let us bring our lives to the Lord in the prayer that our Lord Savior Jesus taught us, as we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thine kingdom come, thine will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And the Lord will become king over all the earth. On that day, the Lord will be one, and his name one. Give thanks to the Lord, for God is gracious. The peace of God which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you, now and always.